Today we're going to be talking about optic atrophy, but not the causes or the workup. We're going to be talking about the morphology. And that's basically, can you look at an optic nerve and tell what the cause was for the optic atrophy? And in general, you can't, because the optic nerve really has only two pathologic responses to disease. It can either swell or it can be pale. However, there are some clues that can be gotten from just looking at the disc head. And so, for example, for non-arteritic anterior ischemic optic neuropathy, that normally is a vascular problem, and so we can see sector pallor. So if it's just like the top of the disc that's affected, and you would have a corresponding field defect, that would be an inferior altitudinal. So the corresponding sector pallor with the field in the right vasculopathic patient who had sector edema that became sector atrophy, that's kind of a clue that that atrophy was from NAION. The other characteristic feature that you're used to is glaucomatous cupping. So cupping is normally a very good sign for glaucomatous type damage to the optic nerve, and you want to be looking for rim pallor to differentiate whether the cupping is equal to or disproportionate to the amount of atrophy. So in glaucomatous optic atrophy, the cupping and the pallor have to be the same, and it has to match up to the field. We wouldn't want to have rim pallor in glaucoma, even though primary open angle glaucoma is probably the most common optic neuropathy that we see. And then you've got post-papilledema optic atrophy. So as you know, papilledema has grades, Friesen grades 1, where you just have a C-shaped halo of nasal elevation, 2, where it's 360 degrees, but we don't have obscuration of the blood vessels, 3, where we have obscuration of the blood vessel as it's crossing the margin, 4, the obscuration is central, and 5 is you can't see anything. So in patients who have papilledema, their atrophy might be able to be distinguished from post-NAION atrophy by the presence of what we call a high watermark. So the high watermark is where the edema used to be. And so if you have grade 4 or 5 papilledema with surrounding subretinal fluid, that fluid will slowly resorb over time. And so the atrophy that we see in chronic papilledema after the resolution has these marks in the retinal pigment epithelium surrounding the nerve where the water used to be. So that is what we would call a high water mark. In general, however, most cases of optic atrophy are actually based on color and not by what we see on the disc. So the disc looks pale. And that's because there's been a change both in the blood vessels, which give the color, the pink color to the disc, but also the astrocytes, when they're replaced by gliosis and there's no more axon, it makes it look whiter. So optic atrophy can be the result of any process that damages the axon and kills it. It'll change the color, it'll change the blood flow, and so all sorts of optic atrophy end up funneling down to a single ophthalmoscopic appearance, which is the nerve looks pale. But you should look out for sector atrophy, cupping, and post-papilledema high watermark to try and determine whether you can tell what the cause of the optic atrophy was. But in general, you can't tell just by looking at a pale nerve.